look at there. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اقتدى واهتدى بآثاره عليه الصلاة والسلام. So إن شاء الله تعالى the lecture of today, just a reminder, inshallah ta'ala, about the istidad li shahri Ramadan al-Mubarak, to prepare ourselves for the blessed month. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentioned in His noble book, shahru Ramadan al-ladhi unzila fihi al-Qur'an hudan lin-nasi wa bayinatin min al-huda wal-furqan, that شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, the month of Ramadan, which is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the Quran. Send down the Quran, and the Quran, and the Quran is the criteria. And there's ayat and bayinat, verses and self-evidence. So from the way of the Salaf al-Salih, our Salaf al-Salih, the pious predecessors, that they will prepare and get ready for the month of Ramadan by making a dua. To make a dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bi iblaghina shahr Ramadan, to allow us to witness the month of Ramadan. To witness the month of Ramadan. From the dua that is al-ma'thur, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa billaghna Ramadan. That Allah bless the month of Rajab and Sha'ban and allow us to reach the month of Ramadan, the month of Ramadan. And al-Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam used to kana yubashir ashabah bi Ramadan. He used to give a glad tidings to his companions about the coming of Ramadan. So there is different ways of preparing ourselves for the month of Ramadan. Firstly, as I've mentioned, with the dua, and that is the way of the as-salaf al-salih, to make a dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to witness the month of Ramadan. Because how many people just one day before the month of Ramadan died, and al-maut came upon them, the death came upon them, or 1 week before Ramadan. So we have to ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make us witness the month of Ramadan, all of it, not just witness it, also to benefit from it. And as the Shaykh Uthaymeen, may Allah have mercy upon him, says, Ramadan madrasa rabbaniya. Shahr Ramadan is a divine school. A divine school to train ourselves to worship Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To train ourselves to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To follow the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to stay away from His prohibitions. To stay away from His prohibitions. So to prepare yourself psychologically is by train ourselves to read the Quran. Because the month of Ramadan is a month of Al-Quran. So to read the Quran. So psychologically, to prepare yourself to know this month is a blessed month. is a month which there's a lot of mercy and forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a lot of people will be freed from Jahannam, wal'iyadu billah, based upon Allah's mercy and ikram, generosity. And to start new page with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala by promising ourselves that we need to stay away from the haramat, prohibitions. Because how many people, they say, when Ramadan comes, I will stop this, I stop that. Ramadan comes and it doesn't stop nothing. He says, yeah, in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, I will stop everything. The last 10 nights of Ramadan comes and it doesn't stop nothing. So we have to have the azima, the motivation to, and we should start it now. We should start now by opening the book of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, reading the Quran, likewise learning the ahkam of as-siyam, the rulings. Maybe we'll do that next week inshallah ta'ala. Today just a reminder to prepare ourselves for the month of Ramadan. So to start training ourselves to be to read more Quran than spending more times on our phones or spending more times on our social media. So we need to prepare ourselves right now. Likewise, by doing the dhikr of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as the Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam mentioned, when the month of Ramadan is about to enter, yunadi munadi ya baghi al khayri aqbil wa ya baghi al sharri aqsir. So an angel call, O seeker of goodness, come forward. Or a seeker of goodness, come forward. As for the seeker of evil, stop. And we know that in the month of Ramadan, the gates of Jahannam closed, will be shut. Likewise, the shayateen will be chained. So that, subhanAllah, that's why certain actions or good deeds will be very hard for you to do it outside Ramadan, but in Ramadan it's easy to do it. It's easier to do it. But if you train yourself to do it in Ramadan, then it becomes like a habit for you. Of course, ibadah, but it becomes part of your nature to do it. So for example, praying the nawafil, praying the voluntary prayers, two before Fajr, four before Dhuhr, two after Dhuhr, so four before Dhuhr, two after Dhuhr, two after Maghrib, two after Al-Isha. So when you train yourself to do it in Ramadan, or if you start now, then it's going to be, especially if you do the whole month, will become part of your nature to pray the nawafil. To pray the nawafil, khasatan, as we know, Salat al-Tarawih, praying the night prayer. So when you get yourself used to pray night prayer, Tarawih, then after Ramadan, if you pray the whole month of Ramadan, then it becomes part of your nature. So after Ramadan, you carry on praying the night prayer. And the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned that the best nawafil prayers is the night prayer, Salatul Layl, has been narrated in the Sahih Muslim, the night prayer. So it is upon us, my sisters, may Allah bless you all, to prepare ourselves psychologically to welcome the month of Ramadan, the blessed month which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the Quran in, or during the month of Ramadan. And in the month of Ramadan, there is a blessed night, Laylatul Qadr. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. The night of Al-Qadr, and what makes you know what the Laylatul Qadr is, and Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months. So this month, we should be very happy to welcome this month. We should be very excited to meet and to welcome this blessed month as a guest. And we should be, you should take care of the guest. You look after the guest, honor the guest. And how to honor this blessed guest, the month of Ramadan? By worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By worshipping Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And abwab al-jannah maftuha fi hadha al-shahr. The gates of paradise will be opened in this blessed month. So the month of Ramadan, my sisters, may Allah bless you. Oh, likewise, those who are watching among the brothers and sisters, is a month that which it's easier for us to do righteous actions. That's why they say al-mahroom, the one who's been deprived, is the one that the month of Ramadan enter upon him or upon her and does not utilize it and benefit from it. As been narrated in the hadith, when the Nabi was making dua, someone was making dua, was say ameen. So the Sahaba, they said to the Nabi, we heard you saying ameen. He said, Jibreel was making dua, and I was saying ameen. And one of the dua that Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam said, that make a dua and guest against someone who witnessed the month of Ramadan and he did not benefit from it. Wal-iyadu billah. So the month of Ramadan is not a month of watching comedy shows. It's not. It's not a month of watching movies. It's not. And subhanallah, shayateen al-ins, they will try to utilize this month to turn people away from the ibadat, from the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for the woman, as Ula mentioned, cooking for the family, that is an act of worship. But also should have a time to read the Quran, should have a time to listen to the Quran, should have a time to do the dhikr of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should change our life. Let's change our life by welcoming this blessed month. And how many families or friends that we know of, they witnessed the month of Ramadan, the last Ramadan, but they died after that. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam walked past by a grave with his companions, and he pointed at the person of the grave. He said, this person, if Allah allow him to come back, the meaning of the hadith, if Allah allows him to come back to this dunya, or to this person, two raka'at for this person is more beloved to this person than your dunya. See, this dunya and this enjoyment within this dunya, sahibul qabr, two raka'at is better than it. Subhanallah. Two raka'at is better than the dunya. For the person who's been buried inside the grave. So that person, what he's wishing for now, we have it. We have this opportunity. He doesn't have it anymore. Or she doesn't have it anymore, but we do have it, alhamdulillah. So my sisters and my brothers and sisters who are watching, if you do not utilize, even if you do utilize social media for da'wah, it's good to turn it off sometimes. To focus on ourselves. Sometimes we focus on other people more than ourselves. So the month of Ramadan is a month to focus on ourselves first. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. Oh, you believe, save yourselves and your families from the hellfire. So to focus ourselves, our family. And the month of Ramadan is a month of Al-Quran. So to read the Quran, try to memorize the Quran, try to finish the Quran, read the tafsir of the Quran. It's not a month of Instagram. It's not a month of Twitter. Especially for those Muslims who have accounts on social media and unknown, or as they call them, influencers. Utilize this month to make people laugh and to turn them away from the remembrance of Allah, then you've been deceived. Al-iyadu billah. We ask Allah to guide you. Then know you are following the footsteps of Satan. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he never utilized the month of Ramadan to make people laugh. Likewise, his companions. Likewise, As-Salaf al-Salih, the pious predecessors. Likewise, the ulama, the scholars. I'm not saying you don't laugh in the month of Ramadan, by the way. But it's not the month that you make videos to tell people away, or videos of mockery and joke, and especially some videos, haram, making people scared. It's haram, even if it's a joke. You're not allowed to make your brother and sister, Muslim brother and sister, scared. As I call them, pranks. It's haram. Even doing a joke is haram, let alone in the month of Ramadan. The month that it is upon the Muslim to utilize it to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my sister, if you're not wearing the correct hijab, then it's a month of Ramadan for you to change. To know that we're not here to please the people. We are here to please Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And to know that if Allah allowed you to witness the month of Ramadan, then be grateful to Allah by utilizing it in worshiping Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. It's a month for us to, for the sisters to stop wearing makeup outside. It's haram for the woman to wear makeup, to go outside showing her face with makeup. It's haram. You know, you're putting people in fitna. It's haram. Don't listen to the people that, those people who try to justify that, they're not going to come with you inside the graves. You'll be inside the grave by yourself. You're not going to take nothing with you inside the grave except your actions. Nor your followers on Instagram, nor your subscribers on YouTube, none of that. You'll be by yourself in the grave. So let us, all of us, including myself, no one is perfect. All of us, we make mistakes. All of us, we fall into sins. So it's a month, Ramadan, to change, to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خاصة especially by reading the Quran, reflecting upon the Quran. The reason there's a lot of depressions and stress and suicides because people turn away from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Especially when you see that amongst the Muslims, wal-iyadu billah, that's Allah salama wal-afi. Because we turned away from the Quran. When you read the Quran and you reflect upon it, Alif Lam Mim, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. Alif Lam Mim, that is the book which there is no doubt about it, guidance for the pious ones. كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليتدبر آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب. Blessed book that we have given to you in order for people to reflect upon it. طه ما أنزلنا عليك القرآن لتشقى إلا تذكرة لمن يخشى تنزيلا ممن خلق الأرض والسماوات العلى الرحمن على العرش استوى له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وما بينهما وما تحت الثرى صاد والقرآن ذي الذكر قاف والقرآن المجيد. This ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praising his book, that this is a noble book. This book is a great book. It's a blessed book. It's a guidance. It's shifa. Lima fi sudur is a cure. It's a cure for the people. But if you have a barrier that is stopping the cure to work, it will never work. Hudan lil muttaqeen, a guidance for the muttaqoon, for the pious ones. Today, likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Alif Lam Ra, تلك آيات الكتاب المبين إن أنزلناه قرآن عربيا لعلكم تعقلون نحن نقص عليك أحسن القصص بما أوحينا إليك هذا القرآن وإن كنت من قبله لمن الغافلين. Alif Lam Ra, تلك آيات الكتاب المبين. This is the ayat of clear book, clear in its tawheed, clear in the legislations, clear in the guidance and the clarification, that to understand this book, you go back to Sunnah. So it's clear. to go back to Sunnah. Sunnah al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wa salam. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us or to allow us to witness the month of Ramadan and to benefit from it. And we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to enter this month upon us and the Muslims with mercy and forgiveness, and to forgive us and our parents, and to make us from those who read the Quran, from Al-Quran, from the people of the Quran. If you cannot read Arabic, read in English, or listen to the Qurra. The Qurra, those who have known from the old ones, the likes of Al-Munshawi, may Allah have mercy upon him, Al-Hudayfi, Al-Hudayfi, and other than them, I mean the new ones, some of them Allah al-Musta'an, become like, as the hadith we mentioned, but listen to those who read the Quran in the correct manner. In the correct manner. So Allah Ta'ala Azza wa A'lam. I think we have a few minutes. Let me take some questions. Advice for new Muslims in Ramadan. I mean the advice for the Muslims to take care of the new Muslims. That's the advice. If a sister she's new, take care of her, invite her to your house to see how the Muslim families come together, breaking the fast, eating together, you know. So to try to be with the Muslim sisters because you don't want to be by yourself. And to Alhamdulillah, the advice that I give is for new Muslims and for everyone. But for the new Muslims, it's for the Muslims to take care of the new Muslim sisters or brothers by welcoming them. But Alhamdulillah, I'm not sure if the masjid they're going to have iftar for the brothers. But so some message they will have, inshallah. So even for the sisters, then you come and break the fast with akhawat. Barakallahu feekum. As for the ahkam, inshallah, next week, do the ahkam, the rulings, inshallah, ta'ala. What if someone thinks we repeat in Ramadan and not now? Repent in Ramadan. This person has been deceived by shaitan because there is nothing guaranteed in this life except death. You know? From our perspective, by the way, yeah? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the rizq is coming to us, guarantee. Whatever Allah decree for us is guaranteed to come to us, no doubt about that. But from us, for sure that we're going to die. Like even the atheists, everyone knows that. That you're going to die. So that's from the shaitan's trick. Deception of shaitan, a taswif, that you repent tomorrow. That's from the shaitan. Rather, you repent to Allah right now. And we repent with the conditions. Some questions, inshallah, I will answer them next week, inshallah, ta'ala. It's the time now. It's 12 o'clock. Yeah, inshallah, ta'ala. Wallahi, this one about how to know is a strong how to know what is a strong opinion in a hadith. If my many ulama take opinion. Which one should they follow? The ulama mentioned the ulama that you are you trust more. For example, some ulama when it comes to hadith, the ulama that you're gonna more follow is Imam Albani because he's strong in hadith. And if you're able to distinguish, then you distinguish. But even if you're able, doesn't mean you mujtahid. But na'am. So if you're able to speak, you know, okay, I'm more convinced with this alim, as long as there's no hawa involved, there's no desires, you know. Strong opinions when they, you read both ulama has adilla, for example. You see, sometimes, for example, if an alim has a qawl, and then you read the other alim, said that alim, the hadith didn't reach him, that's why he said it's haram, but it's halal, because upon this, based upon this hadith, you know, so khalas. But if there is a both a hadith, both of them utilizing the same hadith as a proof, because the hadith is not a nas in this bab, you know, has a different ways of understanding it, then you see which your qalb more relaxed or more happy with or comfort with. As long as there is no hawa, of course. As long as there is no desires, wal'iyadu billah. Just following the sake of looking for any opinions. Yeah, so the, you look at the ulama, which ulama, are, they have adilla with them, and so on, yeah. I think I have to, can you pay back your... Yeah, if you have made up your fasting for the last Ramadan, you can make it now, yeah. After the 15th or not, because it's wajib upon you. Even if you fast on Saturday. I don't know, what is the permissibility of wearing a white wedding dress? I don't know, Allah knows best. Anyway, I'll stop here because it's time. But the other questions, I will answer them next week, inshallah ta'ala. Wallahu ta'ala, a'azu a'lamu sallallahu wa nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi jma'in. Wassalam, salima kathira.